Hello boaters, welcome to Narrowboat Journeys. My name is Phil, and I've lived aboard my narrowboat on the canal system for over 30 years. I share my home with my two cats, Bushka and Midge, and we spend our days travelling around the canal system and making videos. We're on the Macclesfield Canal today at Buglawton, and in this video we'll travel through Buglawton, through Congleton, and then more up on the other side. And this is an evening cruise. It was supposed to be an early morning cruise, but Mr. Midgecat had different ideas about that and didn't come in till late afternoon. So it's an evening cruise, and the lighting is not ideal. It would have been better for a morning cruise, but, well, this is what happens when you've got cats on a boat. Anyway, before we go any farther, let's have a look at the map. We're starting at the yellow marker at the top of the map, then following the blue line down through Buglawton and Congleton to the yellow marker at the bottom of the map. On the way I stopped briefly to get water, and that's the water point at Buglawton there, but otherwise we just go straight on through. Here's the water point on the left, and that's bridge 68 just ahead of me. Unfortunately, all we've got here is a water point, and there is plenty of room here for rubbish and elsan. I don't know why they don't put it in. There's very few facilities south of Bosley Locks. All we've got is a water point here, and then another water point at Hall Green. There's nothing at all in Congleton, which is a great shame. I must say, though, that the water pressure on this tap was very good, and the tank filled up very quickly.
Thank you.
Well, that's the water done. Off we go again. This is a very straightforward cruise. I don't think there's an awful lot for me to say in terms of commentary, but I will chip in on occasion when I think of something interesting to say. Thank you. If you go down underneath the aqueduct, there's quite a nice walk down there. It's quite wooded and pleasant. One way will take you to the small town of Biddulph, which is quite a long way, but the other way will take you down closer to Congleton town centre, but that's also quite a long walk from here. But the aqueduct moorings here, which I'm just be approaching in a moment, is really quite a pretty little spot and very popular. Unfortunately, the lighting this evening does not do this place justice. This is an overflow, and should the water levels in the canal get too high, it will flow over here and drain away down into the valley. This part of Congleton is well away from the town centre, but it's known as High Town, and just to the left of these bridges there's a few shops that you can use, and if you see that boat up ahead, there's a pub near there as well. And here we go across another aqueduct to the right of us. This is probably your closest point you can get to the town centre. It's a fairly longish walk downhill to the shops, and of course that means it's uphill on the way back, but this is known as Congleton Wharf. Good moorings, good visitor moorings. No facilities here, but this is, as I said, this is about as close as you can get to the town centre. So you'd walk on down that road. I've got to be careful, these weeping willows don't sweep the camera off the roof. Sometimes this canal's like being on safari. Thank you. This is Bridge 80, and I'm planning to moor up somewhere just after here. But there does appear to be quite a few boats, so let's hopefully I'll find a nice mooring spot. This'll do. The metal piling's not very good, so I'll use mooring spikes instead of hooks. But yeah, this'll be fine. Looks like it's fairly shady as well. Well, that's it. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you next time.